is below that, my friend.
Yeah.
All right, yeah. Joey, yeah, just below the kneecap. Back with Joey, working on some of those trigger point pull-ups to alleviate tension and stress and inflammation that can be caused just simply by competing and producing or using performance training elements. It's a fancy term for it. You're hitting the ring, okay, going through your drills, you're sparring, you're doing pad work, you're getting a heavy bag, you're running, all that stuff matters. It's imperative that we're doing that work, but how are we recovering? We want to be proactive with our recovery. We want to also respect that over that period of time that we feel more stress. Simply stretching and going through the same process isn't going to fix it. This is what's going to help us get some more real scientific, more comprehensive and efficient recovery. Those trigger point rollouts, we've now made it up to the knee joint. It's imperative that we're rolling this area out junction with the other ankle joint release, simply because for a lot of us, we're trained to stand in that external bias position, and then maybe we create movement in that external bias as we're walking. This can jam up particulars of the shin joint and the shin muscles that are responsible for allowing the ankle to mobilize and move as we walk. If it's offset to one side, specifically that external bias position in the foot, the hips will do the same. And then when you're creating impact on the ground, it can cause a lot of issues in over a period of time. It'll fry your knees, or it'll fry your ankles, or it'll fry your Achilles, or you'll get back. This is all directly related to these components. So it's imperative you release the tissue issue there, allow the knee and all those comprehensive joints and bones to track as we're moving. You can imagine how much more of a demand this is. You are running, jumping, changing direction, pivoting, yada, yada, yada. So it's imperative that we're going after these